Hi everybody, I'm Charlie Nagle, an applied linguist in world languages and cultures, and today I'm going to be speaking to you about the science of language learning motivation, or sorry, the science of language learning, specifically the role motivation plays in second language speech learning. The L2 motivational self system is the dominant model of language learning motivation. It predominantly conceptualizes motivation in terms of three motivational antecedents: the learning experience, idle L2 self, and ought to L2 self. The learning experience refers to immediate contextual variables like the teacher and the classroom environment, and the idle L2 self and ought to L2 self are both future oriented. The idle L2 self refers to learners' hopes and dreams for language learning, whereas the ought to L2 self refers to perceived obligations and responsibilities for language learning and is typically characterized as prevention focused. In both cases, the ideal L2 self and ought to L2 self, like I said, are future oriented, and so learners are trying to reduce the discrepancy between their current self and their future self, and that process guides their motivated behaviors and actions. Now, research has shown a relatively strong relationship between the learning experience and effort and between the ideal L2 self and effort. However, the motivational potential of the ought to L2 self has been called into question. If we put this model into practice, we can imagine two individuals learning a language. One perhaps wants to study abroad and live in Mexico, and the other envisions herself working as an interpreter at the United Nations, and those two goals would serve to orient their effort and guide their motivated behaviors. However, research in this area has predominantly compared learners to one another, which is actually not my interest. My interest is in comparing learners to themselves over time and asking, how does each motivational dimension change over time, and how do relationships between the different motivational dimensions change over time? Turning to L2 speaking skills, we know that successful communication requires a speech that is easy to understand. At the same time, we all have accents in our native language and in the additional languages that we speak, but not all accent features affect communication or have an impact on understanding. The two plots that you see here illustrate that point. On the left, you have a plot of comprehensibility or ease of understanding over time, and on the right, you have a plot of foreign accent or accentedness over time for a sample of novice to intermediate L2 learners. In both cases, lower scores indicate better performance. And you can see that although learners were rated as relatively comprehensible or relatively easy to understand, they were also perceived as having a moderate to strong foreign accent. The other bit that's important here is that both plots illustrate another point in L2 speech development research, which is the window of maximal opportunity that occurs at the outset of intensive L2 exposure. So if you look at those thick, bold lines, which represent the group trajectories, you can see that particularly for comprehensibility, after about 1.5 to 2 semesters, trajectories begin to level off. And so the fundamental question for me then becomes, does motivation catalyze development or accelerate development over time? And could it potentially protect against or mitigate that fossilization or stabilization we see after approximately 1.5 to 2 semesters in this case? And the short answer is yes. Some of my research preliminary work shows that individuals that report a stable level of effort or increasing effort over time tend to exhibit continued growth, at least in certain dimensions of L2 speech. But much more research is needed in this area, disentangling and decomposing motivation into all of its parts. Thank you.